Hi, I'm Crypto Lou, and today I'm going to be taking you through the MyEtherWallet. So I'm going to be covering today what is the MyEtherWallet, how to create an EtherWallet, MyEtherWallet features, how to send and receive, and how to import private keys. So MyEtherWallet is a fast, easy, and reliable type of Ethereum wallet. It's a web-based wallet. However, it's not quite like traditional web-based wallets in the fact that you don't go through and create an account for yourselves. It's more like just giving you access to the Ethereum blockchain. And because you don't create that account, they don't store any information at all, so therefore it's more secure. So if you're currently storing your Ethereum on an exchange, then it can be a little bit risky. So moving across to MyEtherWallet would be a really good step. It's also good if you're doing ICOs as it supports the ERC20 Ethereum tokens. So to get to the MyEtherWallet site, what you need to do is type in www.myetherwallet.com. Now, it's worth pointing out that they don't actually currently have an app. However, a fake MyEtherWallet app made it to number 3 in the App Store recently. That happened a few days ago or so. MyEtherWallet did confirm in a tweet where they then said, "This is not us. We have filed reports and emailed and reported. Would appreciate the community's assistance in getting these scamtards out of our lives." There are also phishing attacks going on at the moment where the emails are going out that has mymyetherwallet.com. So please ensure that you put in the exact address into your address bar, or better still, just save it as a bookmark. So as I said previously, you do not create an account with myetherwallet.com, and they don't hold your keys for you. So therefore, they can't access your accounts, they can't recover keys, they can't reset passwords, and they can't reverse transactions. Therefore, what you need to do is protect your keys and always check that you are on the correct URL. Like I said, make sure that you are always going to www.myetherwallet.com. So what we're going to do now is take us through creating a new wallet. So here you can see you've got the Create New Wallet section. And MyEtherWallet have got some really good help in here as well. So if you wanted to click onto how to create a wallet, it will then take you through all the steps in here. So please feel free to take a look through those. So the first thing we need to do here is enter in a password to create our new wallet. Now this password is really important. Make sure that you remember that. Like I said, they cannot reset your password for you. If you lose this password, you will then lose access to getting into this wallet. So it's really important that you save this or ensure that you always remember this password. So I've just typed in my password. Now this is just a test account at the moment. So I'm going to click on to create new wallet. Next up, what we need to do is we need to save our Keystore file. So you can't actually move along and you can't progress until you've done so. So what you're now doing is downloading your Keystore file, which is UTC.json. Like it says here, once you are downloading it, do not lose it. It cannot be recovered if you lose it. Do not share it. Your funds will be stolen if you use this file on a malicious or phishing site, and make a backup. Secure it like the million of dollars it may be worth one day. So what we're going to do is click on to download. Now what this is an encrypted file that you're downloading at the moment, so it needs to have a password to then open it. Then we click on to I understand and continue. Then we're provided with the private key. So this private key is really important. If you're not aware of what private keys are, this is your lock to your safe. This, if someone got hold of your private key, they would have access to everything in your wallet. They could send and receive as they wish. So with this private key, you can also print a paper wallet version of it so that you have a cold storage copy of that private key. You can then lock it away somewhere private. So for the purposes of this, I'm going to simply copy this. And again, it's giving you those prompts. Do not lose it. It can't be recovered. Do not share it. Your funds will be stolen, and back it up. So now what I'm going to do is click on to save your address. And there are different ways that you can access your wallet. So you can access your wallet using MetaMask or Mist, the Ledger hardware wallet, a Trezor hardware wallet, digital Bitbox, Keystone or JSON file, which is what we've just downloaded, mnemonic phrase, or a private key. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Keystore or the JSON file that I've downloaded. So if I just now navigate to that, it then informs me that my wallet is encrypted and that I need to enter my password. Now what I'm entering here is the password that I put in on the previous screen. So I'm just going to go ahead and type that in now. So you're now presented with your address. So in here is your address to receive funds from others. It then has access to that encrypted file. It has your private key, which is encrypted, and it has access to print a paper wallet in here as well. On your right-hand side here, again, you have your account address, which is your receive address. You have your account balance, which is currently showing as 0 Ethereum, and you can view your transaction history from here as well. You also have access to a QPR code as well, so that you can obviously just scan that. And the private key that's encrypted here. So other features that are available on MyEtherWallet is you can send Ether and tokens, and I'm going to be taking you through that shortly. You can also swap, so you can swap Ethereum for Bitcoin, for example, with the use of Bitty. You can also generate and send offline transactions. You can interact with contracts. You've then got ENS, domain sales. You can check your transaction statuses, view wallet information, and you've got help section in here as well. What I'm going to do is take us through to send Ether and tokens. Now, anytime you want to do something within MyEtherWallet, you have to go through and select how you're going to access your wallet. So again, you would go through, if you have a hardware device like a Ledger wallet, for example, you can use those. What's also really helpful is that if you actually click onto any of these little question marks, it will then take you through to the Ledger site, for example, and it will explain how to use MyEtherWallet with Ledger. It's really helpful, really kind of descriptive of how you actually interact with using MyEtherWallet with the different kinds of devices. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Keystore JSON file again. I'm going to select my wallet file and then click on to unlock. What I can then do is send my Ether token. So in here is where I would put the send address. I would then put in the amount in here as well. Now, if you had tokens already loaded up to here, which I'm going to show you shortly, the tokens would then appear in this drop down. So if, for example, you were sending tokens, those tokens would be available. Now, automatically, the gas limit is set to 21,000. You can go through and change the gas limits. This is how quickly the transaction will go from A to B, for example. And if you want to have a look at information with regards to the gas prices and the gas limits, there's more information in here. So it explains here that the gas price is the amount you pay per unit of gas, and it's paid to miners for including your transaction in a block. The higher the gas price equals the faster the transaction, but it is more expensive. So then what you would do is just simply click on to generate, and your Ether would then send. And like I said earlier, the MyEtherWallet also supports all ERC20 tokens, so all Ethereum tokens, which are shown on the right. Now, because there's so many, you actually have to click on to load tokens. And once those have loaded, you can then view all the different tokens that you can use with MyEtherWallet. As you can see, there's quite a vast amount of different tokens that are supported. If the token that you have isn't available in here, you can also click on to add custom token. One thing to mention with regards to your account address is that you only have one Ethereum address, which then works for Ethereum and also works for your Ethereum-based tokens. So if you're receiving tokens, MyEtherWallet is clever enough that it will then designate and it will distribute those into the correct token balances. Now, I recently invested into the Kick ICO, and I invested using Bitcoin. Now, what was a shame is when it actually went live, is that they actually dealt with all the Ethereum investments first. So I was kind of left waiting quite a long time to actually receive my tokens. So obviously anyone that was before me could obviously go through and sell their tokens before I could or trade with them. So one thing I would recommend is if you are investing into these type of ICOs, you invest with Ethereum as it kind of removes any obstacles that you may face. What I'm going to do now is show you how to import your private keys. Now you may want to import your keys from different types of wallets. I know that some of them that are supported are the likes of blockchain or Exodus. So what I'm going to do is show you through an example now of how to import your blockchain private keys. Now today I'm using a test blockchain account, so it doesn't matter the fact that I'm going to be showing you my private keys today, as you can see at the moment, I've currently got nothing in this wallet. So the first thing you would do is if you go to your Ether, and then if you click on to export private key. Now here, obviously it says granting others access to this private key gives them the ability to send Ether from this address. Exposing your private key to others is a security risk that may result in lost Ether. You will be asked for your main password in order to continue. Now, very similar to any other type of private key, your private keys are
private, for one. And secondly, it's like giving the key away to your safe. So it's something that someone else gets hold of, then they can have access to absolutely everything in your wallet and can send and receive as they please. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to click on to continue. And then if you click on to submit, I've then got access to my private key. So all I'm going to do for the moment is I'm going to copy that private key and close this. If I then take us back to my Ether wallet, and now it's asking me how I would like to access my wallet. And this time what I'm going to do is select private key. I'm going to paste in that private key that I've just copied from my blockchain. And then I'm going to click on to unlock your wallet. So I've now got access to that private key and I've now opened up the account. Should I have had any Ethereum in here, that would obviously show up in here, as well as any tokens that I may have brought across as well. So I hope that you found my Ether wallet tutorial today helpful. And if you did, then please give me a like. If you have any questions at all, then please feel free to put them in the below. And if you'd like to see more tips, reviews, and tutorials, then please hit subscribe. Thanks, and I'll see you soon.